Hello again. This video is sponsored by Paradox, who rather kindly gave me money to play a fantastic game of the new co-op mode in Stellaris with AA, versus Spiff and RT Game, and then to make this video. So anyway, what happened?
Simple question.
Do you mean in the bathroom, or...?
It's a simple question. Do you fold or wipe?
Do you fold or wipe?
Well, today I'll be recounting the tale of two good friends, King George III and his partner in crime, King George Washing Star. In this reality, the Civil War never happened, and America became a strange, joint, but also democratic monarchy with the UK, named the United Kingdoms of Space America. Don't worry about the specifics too much. The UKSM are a civilization of fanatically egalitarian, spiritualist cave dwellers that have massive chins. And that's about as much as you really need to know. They hail from planet Britannomerica, which orbits Anglemerica on the western edge of the galactic center. And the galaxy might look barren for now, but there's something out there. Something dark and festering, in the depths of interstellar space, waiting to be found, or to find us. The first order of business for the UKSM is, as ever, to expand and claim more territories for future resource exploitation. However, in choosing our origin, it appears I've weighed us down with extremely poor jump drive technology, which will stymie our advance at various points in ways that I'll admit I didn't expect nor fully understand. I had intended for us to focus on getting a whole lot of unity and unlocking many cool ascension perks that come with it, so near immediately we got to choose our first tradition tree. Now, I had thought perhaps something useful would be a good idea, but AA suggested harmony, and I find him really hard to argue with, especially when he's waxing lyrical.
Ooh, why don't we go for harmony?
Harmony, 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 harmony.
Few things that can match the strength of a content populace working toward a common goal. Yes, the British and American empires must grow as one.
So now our leaders will live a little longer, which is nice, I guess. My only real goal at the moment is exploration, since as far as I know, Britannomerica is being happily governed by King George Washing Star, and is on the road to great prosperity. It does, however, become fairly immediately apparent that all is not well in the kingdoms. There are food shortages, falling energy and mineral stockpiles, and the royalty has devolved into laughing at the despair of the populace.
That's
okay. Something that we
I think
can...
we might need to... Are we maintaining our ships wrong?
I don't know.
We're losing even more money.
Oh no.
Go sell Why? Some consumer goods. Hang on a second. Let's go to the market
and
sell.
Yeah. We have loads. We have Thank loads you. Of those. Yes.
Yes, good
we,
idea.
We Hang definitely we need won't to. Need those in the future.
We don't need any of these. Hang on a second. Let's do it. Sell them all.
In our explorations, we encounter the Sigma aliens, who are too busy with their Sigma grind set to pay us any notice. They're just mining drones in any case. I'm sure they won't cause us terrible problems. As our exploration continues, the focus of our game shifts from anything useful towards naming our systems things like New Old York, which I think is just the same as New York, but, you know, I just let him cook. The next one was Florida Shire, which is pretty good actually, so that's nice.
Or Galactic Wumbo is the other option.
Galactic Wumbo is good, to be fair. I mean, there will be plenty of places to name. With our dodgy engineering vessels struggling to crawl between systems to build stations, the resource flow is looking pretty bleak. Positive, but nonetheless bleak. So perhaps it's time to settle a new land. New Old York 2 is quite habitable indeed. Therefore, I declare YOLO.
Ooh, we could live YOLO. In New Old
York. YOLO, let's do it. I'm making a colony ship.
New York, Old York 6. Is that what you're talking about? Oh no, that one's not habitable.
No. It's the one with the green. It's the one with the green planet next to it.
Yes, I agree. Can we colonize?
Yes, I'm building a colony ship now.
Good. Space America, who will be the New Old York City? City, planet.
And I realize at this point that we don't have any military power at all. And I'd like to clear these mining drones as they're sitting in what could be a relatively important choke point system. Unfortunately, it's hard for me to really express just how badly our economy is progressing right now. I can say it feels really bad, but I'm not sure that gets my full point across.
Poor quality minerals. Florida Shear the Third. That sounds right on target for us. Yes. We don't have very much here. Let's colonize it.
That planet is going to be so annoying.
It's a tundra where Florida's gotten a lot cooler recently.
Has it?
No,
Yeah, anything for content, I guess.
The idea was floated of settling on the awful tundra planet of Florida Shire, but we instead decided to learn from the mistakes of Earth's America and avoid the place entirely. It's time now for the United Kingdoms of Space America to hold their first democratic election, which I appreciate is confusing, since kings aren't usually elected, but just go with it.
There's an election. I think I'm going to be...
Oh, guy, great, an election! I love an election!
Oh, you might become the president!
Oh, I'm voting for myself! King George Washington!
Don't spend our unity to increase support for yourself in the election. Don't do that.
Yes, let me go fake some votes right here. I'm increasing... I supported myself 4 times for president.
No, you didn't.
I'm going to waste all of our
unity. You actually did!
I'm going to be the president! Now I can be King George Washingstar! Woo! Everybody give it up for King George Washingstar! I'm going to rename myself!
Okay.
Upon stepping into the governor's office of Britannamerica, George III discovered that King Washingstar has been derelict of his planetary gubernatorial duties, having built literally nothing on our capital this whole time. But at least we have Florida Man Planet and Tex Oxford. And now I've learned how George Washingstar managed to steal the election from George.
The election promise was Man Fist the Queen.
Wait, sorry, what?
Manifest the Queen. What did you think I said?
The Queen is dead.
No, we have immortalized her as one of our underground people. How could you be so ignorant?
But there's no time to delve into that particular carcass full of worms. Our distant exploration vessel, the ISS Endless Thorns, has encountered what we're, for now, calling the P-Aliens.
It's them. This is them. I see them. This has to be them. I think it's lying to us with the Hydra thing. Because I can see a space vessel.
Well, I will take command of the military.
Oh, really? Okay, sure. Yeah,
Militaristic combat. Oh, I excel at the military.
It's time to choose an ascendancy perk now, and honestly I don't feel enormously equipped to choose a good one. In any case, I landed on technological ascendancy, because our research feels very slow right now. Which is probably thanks to a distinct lack of research stations being built by our fleet of idle engineering vessels. It turns out when you automate these awful ships that don't have proper FTL capabilities, they just don't do anything. Which is really great. Thankfully, shortly after this, the research for actual hyperdrives shows up.
Faster than light travel is theory. Yes, we will research...
We're Luddites. We can agree.
Yes, we chose to not be able to go anywhere.
Reject civilization. Return to monkey.
Return to monkey. That's what George Washingtonstar famously said.
As the exploration of the Eastern Galactic Zone continues, a wonderful system named Nihal is discovered, but it appears it may be spoken for with the P-Aliens present. Surely we're close to discovering the borders of our nebulous spaceborne opponents now. And we were indeed, as our intrepid scientist Wellon learned all too well on.
Oh no, Wellon has died.
Oh, no!
No! Wait. The P-Aliens seized our vessel and vivisected... What?
Vivisected? Unacceptable!
They...
No one gets vivisected and then lived to tell the tale?
And then shortly afterwards, we made first contact with the nebulous P-Aliens. the Good Friday Space Agreement, as they're officially known, with infamous vivisectors Spiff and RT Game at the helm.
Oh, there they are! With
what
the
should
big
we say
car.
To them? What should go. We say to them? Should we be kind? Or no, we should take the middle one.
See if they want to talk.
Who's this?
They're reaching out.
How are you doing?
Hello. It's going well.
We come in peace. We come in peace, and everything is fine. And do you know what happened to the guy who got kidnapped and vivisected?
Yeah, we suspect something has happened.
We weren't sure us. Who they were, so we just cut into their stomach and had a cheeseburger.
Dan, it wasn't us. It was someone else. Some other aliens came along. They looked a bit shifty. They said they were from Space Florida.
They told us this information later, yeah.
He was tasty. That's all I'll say about that man.
Wow.
He was very tasty. If you didn't want us to vivisect him, why did you make your bodies out of food? Checkmate.
Well, you know what we made our bodies out of? You know what we made our bodies out of? Mixed up coffee and tea.
Ew, disgusting.
Oh,
how could you?
Now it's disgusting. Now that you know what it is, it's disgusting.
Ugh, horrible bodies. Jeez. We just wanted to say, basically, respect our authority or else we hate you and we will kill you.
Oh my god.
Have a lovely day.
Oh, Jesus. Okay. So, now that we have a basis against which to compare just how badly things are going, I'd like to try and get things moving in a more proper direction. Unfortunately, New Old York City is busy replicating its Earth counterpart and becoming a drug-addled hellhole, which isn't helping in that initiative. So I decided that we should start spying on the Friday folk. I assume they're doing the same, so it'd be good to be able to keep our intel fresh so we know exactly how fucked we are in real time. On the bright side, the dimly glowing, distant bright side, we found a Gaia world in the Venkvert system and aim to colonize in that direction as soon as possible. It also appears to be close by another of the galaxy's natural choke points that will be fairly important to fortify. To aid in the fortification efforts, which, whilst well-meaning, aren't going well, I took the initiative and selected Grasp the Void as our second ascension perk to raise our starbase limit. But in case you'd forgotten, most of what's actually happening here is discussion of questionable intellectual merit rather than gameplay.
Jimmy Cartographer, excellent, excellent name. Harambe, yes, the famous American...
philosopher, I believe.
Philosopher.
Shrek. Dicks out.
Do you think that we look too much like Shrek?
What?
Can you look too much like Shrek?
No, I mean obviously not for a start, but... Alright, that's enough fun. A sharp reminder of the mounting tensions between our two space empires occurs in the form of them building a station at this lovely galactic choke point named Imuthin.
Naughty. No! This is my... Damn it!
Once more, I'm still struggling with odd ship behaviors, finding that frigates built as reinforcements are simply deciding to stand alone instead of joining their intended fleet. But the problem with co-op is that you can never be sure whether this is something wonky with the game or just the meddlings of the amphibian, though he seems preoccupied.
The famous scientist Burger King Henry VIII.
Jesus. Okay. He was a large boy.
He was a thick boy and he was a fornicator. Barack Orion. Hazzor, you're taking such good care of me.
Yes.
I love you, Hazzor.
I love you too. Thank you. That's okay.
I like sit here nestled in your generous
bosom.
Teat of...
Teat, okay. Teat, we'll go with teat.
I guess I would say that I suckle from it.
Anyway, at this point we're close to making contact with another alien race. The game was set up with no other AI species, but I think at this point some of the pre-FTL species are starting to make their way into space. More pressingly, an operation started earlier to steal technology from the Good Friday Space Agreement isn't going well.
Taken every precaution prescribed to the
resources,
Oh no. Raise concerns or their cover may be blown.
Bribery. I'm going for bribery.
Why did we name it Operation Steel Technology? That doesn't sound secret at all. Why would we name it that?
I didn't name it, that's just what it is. I didn't
Why didn't we ever give him Operation Tango, Operation... It could have been anything. Operation Don't Steal Technology, for all I care. No, not doing that at all. Nothing suspicious there.
Upon establishing contact with the Tarassians, who I'll simply refer to as the Pig People, they fairly immediately take a subservient stance, offering a non-aggression pact, which is nice, because we definitely aren't getting the same vibe from Spiff and RT. After making a whole set of new science and construction vessels and transferring over the scientists, the old crappy vessels can now be disbanded, meaning surveying, anomalies, and construction can finally be automated. It took a very long time, but now we're where we should have started. It might just be too late though, with the enormity of the GFSA's territory looming in the galactic east. Never mind, something weird is happening on Walmars.
Oh no, another pop has gone... Why are all the people going missing? Oh no, there might be something weird on
Walmart. Let's invest
in
securing it. Let's do
traps
that.
Traps capturing. Should we send our people to just keep disappearing at an odd factory?
Yeah.
Or should we get rid of it?
Well, they'll probably find something good in there eventually, and that's...
No, I think eventually... I mean, that's like real Walmarts. You know? People just keep going in there. We don't really know what happens, but
no
they
one
don't
ever
seem
comes to... out. Yeah.
Okay. It slightly ruins everyone else's happiness, but, you know, maybe you that's know. Okay.
It's worth it. Tensions rise on the borders as an interstellar poop-flinging contest is well underway. Our great system of Theodore Roosevelt is being mocked by the opposing, the better Roosevelt. But then, upon closer inspection...
How can we allow that to happen?
Oh, it is significantly better. Oh, I don't like the First Fleet. The First Fleet is quite a scary fleet. Okay, now seems like a good time for a chat around the galactic dinner table.
Hello, hello, how's it going, gang?
How dare-
Hey, gamers.
How
dare I would
dare
like you to explain the better Roosevelt.
Unacceptable.
Roosevelt. Better? I don't know what to tell you.
It just is. It's just naturally superior.
System. I think you should take another look at the better Roosevelt in its neighboring galaxy system area.
No, we see it.
We see it.
It actually looks atrocious with the capital.
Do you want to know our response? Words. Our response, AA?
Find out operation.
No! This is not good.
Let's. You know what? We can unpause and we can see how this war goes. We're going to. Dan, would you like to do the honors of moving our fleet of 44 ships into Theo Bestor Roosevelt?
Yeah.
Oh,
sure.
No. So, it's war. I mean, that was obviously pretty inevitable, as was the outcome of our first skirmish. They progress some ways into our systems, occupying as deep as Amazon, home of Amazon Prime Station.
Wait, all of your gift subs, all of your Prime subs are ours now, AA,
no.
I'm sorry.
We'll be taking 70-30 revenue split, thank you.
At this point I'm looking around at our borders and feeling rather penned in. These comparatively primitive empires have sprung up around us and grabbed all the space along our south and west borders thanks to our very slow early expansion efforts. All of which leads to a very convincing show of force by the Good Friday Navy.
So we're actually gonna backdoor Thatcher here.
At which point, though, I realize they've still only actually laid claim to our two choke point systems despite their considerably deeper occupation. Edinburgh King and the original Roosevelt. So I quickly surrender before they realize and claim more.
Emperor Spiff is victorious because we crushed our enemy, so the war literally just ended.
I finally figured out I could just do that and send you away. Once we're back to our individual chambers, me and AA agree we probably can't win this in a traditional military manner. So I started to claw back some command of our planets, setting them all to be forge capitals to produce the materials required to desperately fortify our borders, which I realize is probably both too little too late and overkill. This obviously caused other problems like sapping our consumer goods to a rather terrible degree, but I didn't really know that at the time. I was only looking at the now bountiful mineral and alloy counts. Ignorance is temporary bliss, I guess. The pig people have taken their submissiveness to the next level now and decided they'd be better off as our vassals, for some reason. They must be blissfully ignorant to the shambles that is our leadership.
Ooh, let's... Oh, I love it when people want to be subjugated. I'm not naturally that aggressive, but if someone offers... Here we go. Yes!
So that's great, and will contribute to both our trailing economic and military efforts, but I'm not convinced it will be enough to hold off the GFSA. Myself and AA discuss alternative methods for diplomacy. When Dan was talking then, when he had control of that large armada, there was a thirst for blood in his voice. I don't think that there's going to be any way to assuage...
Let's ask them for money.
Yeah, they just insulted us. Now seems like a good time. AA decided to head off to parley whilst I held down the starforts, and shortly after he left, some trade offers started to come my way.
No.
Small quantities of energy credits for a couple of border systems in the central choke point. We started to consider whether our best option is simply to shift the definition of victory to something more aligned with our spiritual goals.
So when things don't go so well, you just reinvent the story. We just reinvent the story. We could. Okay. What do you think of the idea of gradually giving them all of our planets and then just getting a lot of money and then just like basically doing a corporate bailout? You know, like, oh, we couldn't get it. We couldn't get it. And then we go to another galaxy and then we just use the money there. You and me start a different game.
Yeah.
More money.
Yeah.
Would that work?
Yeah, that would work. So I just gave them the Amazon system as a bamboozling tactic. The second stage of the bamboozlement was to start naming our bordering systems as compliments, such as Spiff is cool, Dan is handsome, and Mahatma Gandhi's nuts. Do you come to parley?
I will bring into... Oh, sorry. Parley. Yeah, we got some parley.
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Oh, hey. Hey, how you appreciate
our new just giving us Amazon planet earlier. Names? That was very kind.
Yeah, we like your new planet names. I would like to say, who was in charge of sending us that trade deal for Amazon?
That was me.
You forgot to ask for any money.
No, that's okay.
No, you just gave it to us.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a gift.
You don't understand.
That was
a gift, though.
That was a very generous gift. You know?
Okay, I have a question for AA and Hazzor. Are you more of a fold or a wipe-based individual?
With respect to what sort of activities?
Do you fold or do you wipe? It's a
fold
simple
or
question.
Do
you mean in the bathroom or?
I do both.
It's a simple question.
Do you fold or wipe?
I fold. Okay. Dan, select bring into the fold and declare war. Splendid.
It didn't work. They declared war with the goal of bringing us into the fold, meaning to vassalize us, or as I prefer to say, smear us in Vaseline. Near immediately, the ravaging began, and I know it might at times be hard to keep track of our empire, what with the rapidly changing system names, but they started rolling their fleet through the north choke point and occupying Please Don't Attack Us. Noticing, however, that it appeared that their entire military strength was concentrated as one, admittedly very scary, death stack, I sent a comparatively small counter-attacking force in the form of the Shamed Armada to occupy whatever I could as quickly as possible through the central choke point whilst they were busy up north. The high-pressure situation proved too much for our head of research, Neil Armchair Space, who apparently worked himself to death. And now what happens next can only be described as a triumph for pig people everywhere. I noticed that alongside the Shamed Armada now sat the Tarassian Galactic Corps. Together, me and the pig people applied pressure to the soft underbelly of the GFSA, and I noticed cracks starting to show in Fleet Admiral Rumble Tumble's once bloodthirsty facade.
Hey, everything's gonna be fine.
What? Is this?
Yeah, it's okay.
Woo, go team!
It's okay, don't worry.
I feel a little in the dark.
Yes, there goes King Zorge the Third.
It's okay,
Dan. I knew I could count on you, Hazzor.
However, despite our momentary conquests, our people are not warlike, and are quickly tiring of all this combat. Also, I might have forgotten to watch the angrily boiling pots that are sitting on our galactic stove for just a little bit too long. So, despite the efforts of the Shamed Armada and the pig folk, our automatic surrender started to loom. I ordered the withdrawal of the Armada, only to see it intercepted and destroyed in the Beta Rutabelt, leaving us essentially without any military. And then they started orbitally bombarding Walmars. Rather understandably, at this point, our populace started to worry. They worried rather angrily, mostly by setting things on fire. The first of our worlds to fully secede was Old New York. The first of our worlds to fully secede was New Old York. The space writing is on the space wall here. Our leadership are all dying, with Barack Orion being the next to go. We start to wonder whether perhaps the most fanatically egalitarian thing of all would be for everyone to have nothing.
We could perhaps go the, like, Gandhi civilization route.
What, nuclear option?
Nuclear Gandhi, yeah. Great minds, you know what they say?
Is there a nuke planet decision we can make?
Well, we could destroy our own whole empire. Would that somehow make their victory more hollow? I think that's a good idea. Could we somehow, like, cause our planets? How do we self-sabotage?
Yeah, I don't know how we self-sabotage. I mean, we can destroy all of the production.
Let's go ahead and do that. We could dismantle things. We can't dismantle them while we're at war. Well, who gives?
I'm currently dismantling all of the districts on Britannomerica. So we laid down our ray guns and space paraphernalia and picked up sticks and rocks, with which the system could be systematically bashed out of existence. We leave them nothing to conquer, achieving true enlightenment through a self-imposed primitive lifestyle. For what is victory if not the feeling of inner peace in the face of orbital bombardment? If the GFSA wants to occupy and subjugate us, then let them try. For they who subjugate their own mind stand invincible in the face of an oppressor. And then they did subjugate us and technically, I guess, win the game. But, you know, we won like a weird spiritual moral victory, so it is what it is. I hope you've enjoyed hearing about this as much as I enjoyed playing it. It's always a pleasure to get together with creative people and make something strange and wonderful like this. And it's even more of a pleasure to be paid to do so. Thanks, Paradox. There'll be a link in my pinned comment to go check out Stellaris yourself. They're running a free weekend, you see? Very good. Please, though, whatever you do, remain indoors. Subjugate your mind and gird your loins. It's only a matter of time before the GFSA falls apart and the space troubles get underway. And you don't want to be in the crossfire when that happens. Thanks as ever for watching, and until next time, goodbye.